Nice day, isn't it? Wonderful day. Great time to practice what really works. If you go in and turn on the television now, what do you hear? You hear all this terrible news. So, we can start by saying, I don't have a news problem. I have a continuity problem. And the news is full of all this killing, isn't it? Terrible. So I don't have a killing problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have any killing problem. I have a continuity problem. It's tough to deal with the news, isn't it? Somehow you can't avoid it. You walk into a store and it's awful. So you say, I don't have an awfulness problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a revulsion problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a shooting problem. I have a continuity problem. But by all means, don't listen to the news. Really, practice. But when it tend to, if you hear something, wow, just awful. But I don't have an awfulness problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a reaction problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an abhorrence problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a shrinking away problem. I have a continuity problem. And that's solved how? By this perfectly smoothed out smoothness, by this perfectly smoothed outness. Give up all your problems for this perfect smoothed outness, which is the grace of God remedying the continuity problem for us. I don't have an insurrection problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a civil unrest problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a civil war problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a guerrilla warfare problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a terrorist problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a fear problem, I have a continuity problem, which is solved by this perfect smoothed outness that some of the great showcasers of this have shown us. We've had several recently. Ramana Maharshi was one, and Ananda Maimon was another, and there are some others too, from other various traditions, which they showcase this perfect smoothed outness and saying, just abide in this perfect smoothed outness. But to get there, what I'm seeing is the quickest, directest, most direct, potent way, which we need right now, is to say, I don't have a fear problem. I have a continuity problem. Whatever problem arises, say, I don't have that problem. I have a continuity problem. Because the continuity problem, two sides of one coin, one side is accepting you have this problem, the other side is the resolution, the smoothed outness, where there is no, not even a ripple. No matter what happens in the world, there's not even a ripple. It's like seeing the screen of a television set instead of all the stuff that's happening. You're just aware of the screen, it's just totally smooth, glassy screen. And you're not, whatever's the play of light and news on the screen doesn't affect the smoothed outness of the screen at all. But this is just a metaphor. We're talking about an actionable smoothed outness that we feel everywhere. I don't have a riot problem. I have a continuity problem. So no riot problem for me. Don't have a riot problem. Don't have a vandalism problem. I only have a continuity problem. don't have a protest problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't have a security problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't have a political problem. I have a continuity problem. Just one problem. Just one problem. That's all I have. Just one problem. A factional problem, just have a continuity problem. I just have a continuity problem. Don't have a global problem, just have a continuity problem. I only have a continuity problem. That's it. But certainly the news and what's on television is the poster child for not doing what's right. And I really advise you to not watch television or listen to radio. I don't do either. I do watch occasional golf tournament. Might check to see, you know, see the serene, kind of beautiful, relaxed atmosphere. But then they hit you with the trailers and the commercials and all that stuff. It's not good. Trying to stay away from television, stay away from radio, stay away from the newspaper, internet news. Just don't pay any attention to it, because you say, look, I don't have a news problem. Whatever is in the news, I don't have a news problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an event problem. I have a continuity problem. See, it doesn't matter what events happen. I don't have a problem with events. I don't have an event problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an information problem. I have a continuity problem. It doesn't matter what happens in the world, what the information is. It doesn't matter. I don't have an information event problem. I don't have an information problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't have an unrest problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't have an agitation problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't have a news event problem. I have a continuity problem. We have to, really, at this time in the world, face the problems head on like this. It's not like it used to be. And the world has amped up its defensiveness to an extraordinary extent. Its determination to try and forget reality entirely as a way to solve the fear problem of God. That's the ego's plan, is let's just forget reality totally forever. And let's just immerse ourselves in problems, right? Because there are no problems in reality. How do you forget reality? Well, of course, you immerse yourself in problems, fragment your identity, try to have a fragment identify with all these little fragments and all the problems that they have. It tends to put you into this deep, deep sleep, a coma, forgetfulness of reality. And the ego says, look, if you just forget it entirely, no problem. No continuity problem, right? You're never going back. It's impossible. We've never left. So we have to realize that we're still there. We're still one with reality. Reality is oneness, everywhereness. So that doesn't work. The ego's plan doesn't work, and eventually everybody, one way or the other, finally starts to recognize this, say, uh-oh, I got a continuity problem, because the ego's way doesn't work. Of course, it doesn't work. So we have a continuity problem, absolutely. So face it head on, and say, yes, I do have a continuity problem, but all this other stuff, it's not a problem. It's not a problem for me at all. I have a continuity problem. This other stuff is just imaginary. See, I don't have a shooting problem, it's the news. I don't have a shooting problem, I have a continuity problem. So stand up to the bullies. The biggest bullies in the world right now are the news organizations, okay? They're the biggest bullies on the block. Television is the biggest, and television, Hollywood, those are the biggest bullies in the world right now. Absolutely. And they are bullying the whole world into the ego's direction of trying to totally forget reality forever. So there's no continuity issue. Again, doesn't work, so you gotta stand up to these bullies. Just speak truth to authority. Speak truth to the bullies and say, I don't have a bully problem, I have a continuity problem. Leapfrog over the whole thing. But, you know, we have to stand up to the bully at this time. And it's a very, very big bully for sure. And behind those bullies are even bigger bullies. I don't have a cosmic problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have an ET problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a reptilian problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have an elite problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have an Illuminati problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a media problem, I have a continuity problem. You can do this, but again, don't fixate on it. I don't have a fixation problem, I have a continuity problem. Because just, if you don't have that problem, say, okay, I'm moving on. I don't have that problem. What's the next problem I see? I don't have that either. I don't have that either. Don't argue. These are affirmations, not arguments. Don't dispute. This is not a disputation. This is a statement of fact. It's an assertion of fact. I don't have a global problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a media problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a news problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a breaking news problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a natural disaster problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a tsunami problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have an earthquake problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a flood problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a plague problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't have a typhoon problem. I have a continuity problem. Just statements of fact. Statements of fact. If you don't make statements of fact, you'll be making statements of unfactual statements. And the world will continue on saying, oh, I have all these problems. I have a typhoon problem. I have all these problems. Those are all being generated by us, forced by mind. Those are imaginary problems to try and help us hide from the fear of God, which is an unjust fear, dishonest fear, because we projected our attempt to dispossess God of reality. And then the fear we felt from trying to do this, because we are reality, where reality is one. We felt, oh my gosh, something's trying to dispossess us of everything. And then we blame God for that. Instead of being honest and saying, no, it's because we wanted to be greater than God that we feel this way. So we've been hiding from this fear of God. Hiding from this fear by trying to parse it into all these little problems, all these problems that we have. And say, well, it's not a total problem. We've got individual problems with this individual. I have this problem, that problem. And you know, time and space. All this stuff is a way to try and manage this fear. I don't have a time-space problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a management problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a strife problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a violence problem. I have a continuity problem. If people would just use this, everyone would ascend, so to speak. The world, we would ascend into the paradise, death-free realm, actually. Absolutely. You can be in the worst place in the world, most crime-ridden, fearful. If you make these assertions, you will ascend. I don't have a violence problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have have a danger problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a defensive problem. I have a continuity problem. The situation is that people don't practice this. They won't practice. Say later, and they'll stay. So they'll stay all these problems, of course. So it's just a matter of actually applying this technique. That's it. But how do you get people to do that? it's up to each one of us. You know, it's up to the Holy Spirit and working with each one of us. Most usually we don't apply what we actually can do. So I don't have an application problem. I have a continuity problem. That's how you apply it. Is whatever defense you have against doing it, name that defense and say, I don't have that defensive problem. I have a continuity problem. You see, this is like spiritual jujitsu, right? Totally. Because whatever objection we have, just name the objection and say, I don't have that problem. I don't have an objection problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a practice problem. I have a continuity problem. So when you say, oh, I can't practice this, I say, wait a minute. I'm saying I have a practice problem. Oh, name it, okay? I don't have a practice problem. I have a continuity problem. Because all of our defenses against not doing this come from the continuity problem. So just admit it. It's just honesty. Honesty is the best policy, for sure. I don't have a dishonesty problem. I have a continuity problem. Like that. Whatever your resistance, just notice it. Don't get demoralized by it. Don't say, oh, I can't do it. I don't have a I can't do it problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a failure problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a give up problem. No, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a futility problem. I have a continuity problem. And the experience is just like, wow, I can stand up to these bullies, these problems, and deny them. It's just like, oh, I didn't know I could do that. I didn't know I could do that problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an awe problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an attachment problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an identity problem. I have a continuity problem. Now, as you realize, the news isn't getting any better, is it? For years I've been pointing this out. I said, look, keep moving towards practicing and clarification, because the news is not going to get any better. It's going to get worse. And worse and worse and worse. Don't sit there hypnotized by it, saying, oh, I hope you get better news. I'm going to tune into the news today hoping it's going to be better. No, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. Instead, I don't have a bad news problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a false hope problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a temptation problem. I have a continuity problem. Shift it all over to the continuity problem. Whatever weakness you have, I don't have a weakness problem, I have a continuity problem. And your mind is like, you know, it's just like, mind's not used to this. It's like, wow. You're not being bullied anymore. And then when you get to a point like you get this reaction, like, wow, then you can just be. I've reached that point right here. It's kind of like a miracle. It is a miracle. Like, wow, I didn't know I could use my mind that way. Nobody ever told me I could use it that way. I don't have a mind problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a practice problem, I have a continuity problem. See, if we start not being able to practice, just turn it around like that. I don't have a practice problem, I have a continuity problem. And that automatically is practice, isn't it? So you'll feel it when you practice, keep practicing until you reach this point where you feel something is just like, wow, your mind is sort of gasping, you know, like gasping for air, like, wow, I didn't know I could do that. Amazing. I don't have an amazement problem, I have a continuity problem. Feels like at some point you say, okay, let me just let that smooth out just a little bit. That's what's this? Something here. I don't have a distraction problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a people problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a social problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a conflict problem. I have a continuity problem. Turmoil problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't have a turmoil problem. I do not have a turmoil problem. I have a continuity problem. Reframe the entire situation. Reframe the entire situation. Every facet of the frame that we have now, name it and say, no, I don't have that problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a perception problem, I have a continuity problem. Whatever arises, whatever objections, just turn it around. I don't have an objection problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a meditation problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a contemplation problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a success problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a pollution problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a resource problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a distribution problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a poverty problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an inequality problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a discrimination problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a justice problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an unfairness problem. I have a continuity problem. See, the media's got all the trumpets, and they're trumpeting from everywhere and saying, these are your problems. No. My only problem is the continuity problem. I don't have an activist problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a pressure problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a social media problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a social media problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a pity problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a sorrow problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a grieving problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a shock problem. I have a continuity problem. So it's time for all this for us to stand up to the bully. The ego is bullying the world, for sure. Trying to. I don't have an ego problem. I have a continuity problem. Goodbye, ego. Yeah, you know, goodbye, ego. Say goodbye. Do you say goodbye to ego by saying, I don't have an ego problem. I have a continuity problem. No more ego. Just a continuity problem, which God smooths out for us perfectly. I don't have a technology problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a nanotech problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a big pharma problem. I have a continuity problem. Big ag problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a GMO problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a legal problem. I have a continuity problem. And I don't have an ego problem. I have a continuity problem. This deflates the ego. This just deflates the ego. Lets all the air out of the ego's balloon. I don't have a personal problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an individual problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an action problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a charity problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a compassion problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a church problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a quicksand problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a chaos problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a chaos problem. I have a continuity problem. There you go. Very powerful. I don't have a chaos problem. I have a continuity problem. So I'm making these videos here, so they will be available to watch as we go forward, and I'll be able to, you know, keep on doing what I can do. But at least these will be available to go back and look and practice. These are like practice videos here, to practice this simple technique, which evaporates your karma. It evaporates your attachment. It evaporates the ego. It evaporates your problems. It evaporates all of this. And I don't have an evaporation problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't let any concept get on top of you. I don't have a conceptual problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't let anything get you down now, no matter what it is. Name it. Say, I don't have that problem. I have a continuity problem. That's it. Nothing more than that. It's that simple. Whatever you see, whatever problem the world's trying to push on you, say, I don't have that problem. I have a continuity problem. That's the way. This is the way that is going to work. And if people say, well, you're unloving, I don't have an unloving problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a love problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't let anybody intimidate you and tell you you have any problem whatsoever except the continuity problem. And you accept that for yourself. So, you know, when you accept it for yourself, you take away all the leverage from the ego entirely. It can't push you around or intimidate you in any way, including all the ways that, well, you're not spiritual enough, you're not loving enough. I don't have a spiritual problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a loving problem. I have a continuity problem. Stand up to the bullies. There have been some big bullies in the world. There's some big bullies now. We can stand up to them using this technique. I don't have a bully problem. I have a continuity problem. Just do it. Just do it. And you'll feel the effectiveness of it. It's like, it's real. It's empowering yourself with truth. I don't have an empowerment problem. I have a continuity problem. Again, always round it out that way. So the clever tricksters cannot get you hooked into trying to work with some problem. I don't have a trickster problem. I have a continuity problem. So stay centered in that acknowledgement. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a centeredness problem. I have a continuity problem. Round it into that always, always. And you'll find, you know, you're getting unhooked from all the hooks that get into you in this world. There's so many hooks. There's so many hookers in this world that hook you and try to hook you into solving some problems for them. Because they can't. See, they can't figure it out, and they got problems. I get some people to solve problems for me, and then I'll be okay. No. Get unhooked from all of that. Get unhooked from it by acknowledging I only have one problem, and it's the continuity problem. That's it. I have no other problems. Period. I don't have a hooked problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an entrapment problem. I have a continuity problem. So we're here. Better late than never, actually. It's much better late than never. You certainly didn't want to fail to get this technique in time. You certainly wanted to succeed, and so we have it now, so we just use it. All right. Just keep at it. That's it for this one.